Welcome, listeners. I'm your humble host, Joe Williams. Thoughts on business topics of some importance. You're listening to The Radcast. Human interaction. When considering social distancing, or what I would rightly label as physical distancing, there is a large deduction of what really binds us together in human social behavior. There are certain hormones in mammals called social hormones that are released with humans in the flesh when interacting. These are oxytocin and vasopressin, and they serve a very unique role in helping us strengthen positive social bonds with each other. In absence of the interaction in physical distancing, we can default to our paranoid reptilian brain, where everyone is a suspect as prey, a lack of trust. With mass doses of fight-flight stress hormones are released, and this causes our body energy to be devoted towards hypersensitiveness of the fright in the world. The pattern keeps continuing with large dose of narrative-driven current events that is often negatively political or sensational to our eyes and ears, along with a social norm that everyone must keep away from each other out of fear of harm. The more this continues, the more the separation and harm one will do to themselves and society. This heightened stage of stress hormones, pumping adrenaline and vasopressin, causes fatigue, depression, and weakened immune system over time. None are good for you. I'm seeing the stress being played out in social media, where communication is becoming more vile. People are beginning to cast blame and shame. Compliance and social order is confusing, and the uncertainty for the future has become a desperation of security and normalcy that no one agrees to. We only need to listen to ourselves and to begin the process of bringing back our social hormones. Work and hobbies will only bring so much. The human touch is the spirit that will bring most of normal back. We all need a hello from a stranger, a friendly handshake, a pat on the back, a close hug. That common bond we all can find in each other if we only can start again by being the first to say, "How are you?"